Radio Hereford FC, the only station with full match commentaries of the Bulls, every game, every week.
Well, hello again and welcome to We're Going Down the Pub with me, Frank Williams. You know, it's the same intro every time, isn't it?
It is.
And the ground...
You didn't expect it though, eh?
The ground guide guru, Mr. Simon Wright.
I'm still embarrassed when you call me that, but I'll put up with it somehow. It's been a while though, hasn't it?
Well, yes, it has.
Having
really.
One seeming like every week, it's been a bit of a gap.
Get so many there,
No, joy.
But mind you, the day that we have eight successive home Saturdays would be great.
Yeah.
It's not going to happen.
No, I can imagine Jamie would be a bit worried if it did, our programme editor, but he's struggling a bit,
Right, okay, Bridgewater Town.
Bridgie, now this has been a bit of put together from our various sources. Bit job, I'm afraid.
But we do have a man on the spot.
Well, we did. David Mortab, one of our local southern baggies, did his very best. But it's the ground was always closed and he went there and the phone went unanswered. For reasons that we'll come on to in a moment.
Yeah. Okay.
So we did have some gaps. The vice chairman of Bridgewater has given us some extra details this week.
Excellent.
That aren't going to be in the programme, so pin your ears back.
Yep, you're only going to get it here.
Exactly, but overall, details are a bit sketchy, so if there's some gaps, we tried, but,
Well, one thing is, we do know where the ground is, which is helpful, so at least we can get we can probably get you there one way or another.
Exactly,
Very little else.
We got some gaps, haven't we? But I think we better explain the background, We thought we've had problems in the last few years. This is the fifth football club in Bridgewater. It's a rugby town, sadly. The other four football clubs all folded, and this 1984 version is struggling. It seems like pretty much everyone was sacked or retired or resigned to the back end of last season. Right down to the bar staff and the groundsman and the sponsor and the manager, just about everybody now. So what's left is a completely new and understrength committee trying to run everything and make sense of it all.
Hence, locked our doors and announced the calls.
Exactly. Yeah. It's not really surprising. Routine inquiries aren't being picked up. They've got a new manager.
Mm-hmm.
Jamie Laird's dad, Craig Laird, one of the Laird dynasty.
Yeah. Well, they've already played at our place anyway.
They have, yes.
Yeah, and Jamie played in that game.
He did. They probably wished
he left.
Yes, he's gone to Western, isn't
he? He's joined Box at Western.
Yeah, it's all a bit circular, isn't it? There you go. Probably Jamie wished he didn't play at Hereford after the 6-0, but there you go.
Yeah.
And Craig Laird is trying to manage with a new, very young and cheap squad.
Yeah.
And I suspect some of them are probably students from Bridgewater College next door.
Yeah. In fact, don't they share training facilities?
Yes.
There's another ground
parking.
Next door.
Yeah. And, as you said, Jamie has bailed out. I mean, it's never good to lose your Jamies, as we know ourselves, only very recently.
Well, you lose a lot of Jamies in this game, don't
Yes, you do.
And gain a lot.
We need to gain some more, don't we?
Yeah.
Town are having a rotten season, and that's been polite, really. And, of course, that creates some pressures, They recorded their first win of the season in mid-October. They actually beat Tiverton, which gobsmacked everybody.
That's a huge favour.
We're very grateful,
Absolutely.
And, they got a bit carried away as a result, and then they lost the next game 5-0. And then they lost the game after that 5-0.
That must have been some game against Tiverton.
Yes.
How can that happen? It does, doesn't it?
It's a freak.
It's football. You see, it could happen to us at any time. I remember Bees saying, one day we're going to play poorly and take somebody apart. Yeah. Really, one day we're going to play brilliantly and get taken apart ourselves. It's going to happen.
It's
going to
happen.
Point.
You're right.
Yeah.
Now, Now, there's no info on the players or the new committee on the website, so there's not much more we can add.
Well,
maybe they knew we were coming.
We knew one of them.
There was a goalkeeper on there, wasn't there? That was it. But perhaps they knew we were looking and took it off because they don't want us taking the Michael out of them like we do so many other clubs.
Of course,
but
we can best help them.
Yeah, exactly.
The club in trouble by turning up and spending our money.
Exactly.
Yep.
Turn up in big numbers and
absolutely
spend your dosh at the ground, you know, if you possibly can and willing to.
Yep.
And, you know, obviously it's a new ground. It's not a huge distance away. It's only 90 miles. So
is it as old as the club then? Is it?
It is. It's
1984.
Yep, 22 years old, Fairfax Park.
Yep.
Decent ground, room for 2,500.
Right.
302 seats in a pair of low stand. They don't match, but hey, never mind. They face each other on the touchline. This
wooden steps. Only wooden steps, do you
oh,
know?
Oh, I don't know. I wish I did. You
never
know?
Mind,
no,
Rob.
No.
Never mind, Rob, if you're out there and you're listening.
Yeah.
You know what I mean. Just take a bit of care this time that you don't have trouble
well,
with the wooden steps.
Well, I need a favour of Rob, so let's not wind him up too much.
Yeah.
Okay, there's room for 400 more in cover terrace. There's two covered terraces. Sorry, there's one big one, 360. Another one, a shed. I know you love your sheds.
Ah.
Yeah, room for 80 in that shed. I know it's quite
another
a big shed,
shelter.
I suppose.
Another
yeah.
big buck
yeah.
shelter, that is. Yeah,
and according to Bob, who's the vice chairman of Bridgie, they're hoping for a 1,000 gate, which frankly sounds terribly optimistic. So I have sort of, whoa, hang on a moment, 1,000's a lot of people.
Hmm.
And 200's a good gate for them, so they're
yeah.
relying on us an awful
yeah.
lot.
Well, it would be nice if we could pull out the stops.
Yes.
But as people, you know, as other clubs pulled out the stops to help
yep.
us when we were
That's
in trouble.
Right. Yep.
We had all those people from all over the country who joined the trust to help us out when we were
Even
in
people
trouble.
From Brighton. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, really? Oh, never mind. No, forget it. Don't bother everyone. No, no. Do.
Yeah.
You know, if you can get to that game and
yes.
spend a little bit
yep.
of your money, you're going to be helping another
exactly.
club in need.
Okay.
Nobody wants to see a club go under.
No, that's right. Well, let me tell you a bit more about parking and refreshments.
Okay.
Guess what? There's,
what?
There's egg chasers next door.
No.
Again.
How many pitches have they got? About seven, I suppose.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. And what a surprise. They're at home at the same time.
Oh, gracious.
Again. Who does this stuff, you know? But thankfully, car parking should be okay. 70 spaces by Bridgewater's ground, 80 more along the access road, and the college has 600.
Ah,
so
of course they have links with the college.
Exactly,
so, yes,
so
right,
one way
okay.
or another, we'll be fine.
That
there.
Shouldn't be too
okay.
bad.
No.
Right.
Now, refreshments, sorry, this is a bit of a patchwork job. The bar is a decent size. Anybody who went to Swindon, imagine that bar size doubled, and apparently that's the size of Bridgewater's bar, so that's a decent size.
Right, yeah. Mind you, Swindon's was small.
Well, that's right, but, you know.
Well, I say it was small, I don't know, I didn't get in it.
Oh, did you not?
Not at all.
Frank, you signed the pledge. You feeling
no,
all right?
It's so busy setting up.
Oh, right,
didn't,
right.
Didn't get
right.
It. Anyway, we've had rather a nice meal and drink it with the Crown, wasn't it?
Yes, Crown Strap.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Great.
Yes.
Anyway. I didn't feel the need.
Okay.
And I knew it wasn't a club in desperate straits. So.
No, not like this one. No. I mean, I got talking to some Swindon supporters in the bar, of course, who'd just been to Bridgewater themselves the previous week. Now, they remember that tribute has been served, which is it's a decent pint. I'm very happy to knock
St.
that
Austell.
Back. Indeed.
Yep.
The rest, they said, was okay, we're moving on rapidly. latest from Big Bob, I'm guessing he's big, but Big Bob, the vice chairman, Bridgie, they're still finalising arrangements what they're going to sell. Now, I have pointed out to them, if they can name a real ale, it's going to help. It's going to get people in the bar.
But they've got to serve it as well, though.
Of course.
It's no good just naming it.
No.
I can name loads of them. Look, we're yep. sitting here at the Wagon Horses.
Exactly.
And there's 70. I can name them all.
Yeah.
I can't
okay.
drink them.
No, this is very true.
Okay.
You put me off my thread now. But and I also said to them, we are very fussy about our cider, and we do not want Suffolk cider, and we're not that keen on this Somerset stuff either, but, you know, there you go. Now, if we do get an update, I'll share it through the website and, you know, and encourage people to come along. One point Bridgie did want to make, that they do have we'll be selling cans of alcohol elsewhere in the ground to ease congestion. So right. if you're not fussy about quality, or you're a lager drinker, which is the same thing, look out for your can banks, you know.
Yeah, you better watch your back, haven't you?
Okay, next door to the clubhouse is Dave's Diner. Now, Bridgewater are pretty proud of the range of food that they do. It seems slightly wider than usual.
I know you missed it, but it won't be as good as Wimbledon's.
No. Well, who is, though, to be fair? Okay. They will be doing pizza. They always do pizza.
Well, perhaps it will.
Yes, and they are costing out a hog roast just for us. So, you know, if that comes off and they let us know, we'll tell the world and get that hog demolished.
That's
you know?
really nice.
Mm. Yeah. Could be really good, Gunzit, okay. Adissa Balls, come on, guys, come and join us. You've got everything you need. You've got your own dedicated loo, accessible via a ramp, allocated spaces in the main stand. As far as we know, all the pavements are flat, okay. Okay, now... Alternatives, you know, if everybody crams in the bar, there's going to be room for everybody. So yeah. The Overflow might want to think about the nearest pubs. They're in Bath Road. The Sportsman at number 73 looks closest. The Sportsman.
At number 73. So yeah. Is that number 73 Bath Road?
Yes.
I've never known pubs.
Called Sportsman at number 73. Okay, at number 73, the Sportsman is the closest pub. Doesn't have any real ale, but it's a traditional boozer by the look of it.
Yeah.
Nearest proper beer is the nearby New Market Hotel in Lower Bath Street. They have a range of guest ales, but they won't say what they are.
So there's one in Bath Street and there's one in Lower Bath Street.
Right, one's a continuation of the other.
Yeah.
The opposite end of Bath Street, it's obviously a very big bath, is the...
or a very long street.
Indeed.
The two, yeah.
The other end of Bath Street is the Cross Rifles. That does Old Speckle Hen, also does Doombar. Moving on.
I know you don't like Doombar.
That's because somebody does.
No, but it's not that. I know there's a lot of it about. That doesn't mean to say it's bad. It is.
Yeah.
It is, but it doesn't mean to say it has to be bad.
Yeah.
It may be very good there.
Yeah, fair enough.
But you doubt it.
Try it. Go and try to the Cross Rifles and tell me what you think.
Well, you wouldn't if there's Speckled Hen on. You're not going to try the Doombar,
no,
are you?
No, this is very true. Now, we have to mention the Wetherspoons because otherwise people get cross. The nearest Wetherspoons is the Carnival Inn, which is named after the carnival in the town, surprisingly enough. That's about a mile walk, so you know, to help with the old exercise routine. That's in St Mary Street.
No shortage of real ales there, then.
No, and Strongbow, if you can manage Strongbow. I suppose it keeps some people working the same.
I know what you're going to go now. You're going to go. You've done your pubs. You're going to start talk. Are you going to talk food or are you going to talk cake? I don't know which is going to be. You tell me. Well, are you talking food or are you going to just talk?
I've been so lampooned for cake.
Mm-hmm.
I know. I think we're going to raise the stakes a bit here. We're going to look at a serious eatery that's rated by the good folks of Bridgewater, and I'm going to mention a Turkish restaurant.
Don't tell me. It should be in Bath Street. Shouldn't it?
It ought to be, really, isn't it?
But it isn't.
No, sadly, in West Quay, overlooking the river.
Turkish Bath Street would have been brilliant.
Yeah, Turkish. Yeah. If you're into meze... Turkish meze, I must admit, I've never tried a Turkish meze.
He played very well for Barcelona last night, but they lost.
That could quite put me off my words now.
Okay, I'll tell you, mate. It's open from noon.
It's open from noon. Thank you very much.
So you've got time. You've got time for a Turkish meal before the game.
Exactly. And how many football matches can you say you've nipped in for Turkish meze beforehand?
None.
No. No. There you go. It's the only Turkish restaurant in the whole of the county, so we're able to try it. Bit of culture. It's a very pleasant town, genuine history. Mm-hmm. Got a very pleasant river parrot running through it.
Yes, the river parrot.
I presume it's not a dead parrot. I'm sure it moves all by itself.
It is an ex-parrot. It is no more. It has ceased to be.
So if it's not too cold and you're there...
No relation to Ron, am I?
No. Goodness me.
Or John, for that matter. But no, it's parrot with an E, parrot.
Parrot, yes, indeed. Yeah. Okay, so that's the quick run through. By train, yes, you can do it, but you might take an age doing it. It's 3 hours there, 3 hours back, and involves two changes.
Right.
Once you're there, it's fine. The ground's only 650 metres from the station. But bizarrely, it's annoying because the train line runs right past the ground.
Yes, it does.
So you just wave.
Yes, it goes past the ground, and then you have to walk back from the station. Now, Reg can do it
a lot longer, a lot quicker than 3 hours, can't he?
Now, I did ask him to make sure he got some stuff up before we did this recording.
Well,
and then we didn't bother doing the recording when we said we did. But it's all up there now on away days. It's 15 quid, leaving at 10 o'clock,
we think.
10 o'clock. There'll be lots of stopping up places. There will be the usual, I expect, Ross, Monmouth, Chepstow. It's £15. All the details are on Hereford Away Days on their event page.
Now booking their second coach.
Yes, they are. And
good
you can book. You don't have to text now. You can still text his mobile number, which is there on the page, but you can also just put your name, your link name, on the event. And
he's an obliging chap, isn't he, to make it so straightforward.
Yeah, it'll... it should be a good day out now. What a date of the match? But there you are.
It seems ages ago away now. 19th?
Is it? Must be.
Yeah. We've got all those home games before that.
We're going to get seriously into winter soon, and it's one of our longer trips, I think.
Bridget, now 90 miles, not that bad.
No, but we haven't got many more long trips to do. We've done most of them.
No, we got not until March when we do Sainsbury's again, and it's a long way to go to the supermarket, isn't it? And and Biddeford, yes.
Yeah.
Watch this space. Thank you for listening, folks.
Yes, and we'll
Be back with the Mangoes next, I would imagine.
Oh yes, it'll be Mangosfield next.
Yes.
Big game.
Bring it up.
At the top of the table, and our away form is such. It's going to be worth a good visit.
Yep.
Okay, we'll see you soon. Thanks very much for listening.
This is Radio Hereford FC, the home of the Bulls. Match Day Live.